slightly surreal.
And surreal.
Surreal.
Coincidence.
Strange, almost surreal puzzle going on at the moment.
Surreal.
Surreal. Totally surreal. Well surreal. Double surreal. What does surreal mean? Does it mean anything? Is it merely a synonym of strange, lazy fancy speak for weird? What do you, the people, think it means?
Yes, I do know what it means. Is that it then?
Funny peculiar? Funny ha-ha?
Well, spot on both, I suppose. So I'm booting with a Bailey's top, my brother.
I don't think so, sisters.
It means bizarre.
It's that bizarre feel, isn't it? Yeah. Bizarre.
I thought you said I could be Tsarina.
It does mean bizarre, but the tamed end of bizarre. The surrealists of the 20s and 30s took the bizarre out of the wild and incarcerated it in a zoo. They domesticated a feral instinct, expunged the savagery, sought to keep it for themselves and their precious movement. When, of course, the irrational really belongs to all of us, to all ages, if not to all cultures.
Well, it's two words, isn't it? Sir meaning self, and real meaning royal. Royal self. Surreal. Olé.
Wrong. Wrong etymology. But surrealism did come from the South, and the artist with whom it is regrettably most readily associable, the 20th century's aptest anagram, Avida Dollars, was nothing if not a fawning royalist.
So fawning indeed that after he was presented to HRH Queen Elizabeth II of England and to the Duke of Edinburgh, Dali's anxiety not to display lèse majesté was such that when he took his leave of the royal couple, he declined to turn his back on them.
What a splendid example of un act gratuit, Philip. How generous of Senor Dali.
To destroy is to create, old thing. Totally surreal.
Do you remember that story Uncle Louis's friend from the old country told us about Senor Dali? Oh, what was he called?
Herr Max Ernst. He was well surreal.
But what was the name of that common little man who...
Boonwell. Too surreal by half, if you want my opinion.
Signor Dali was quite right to get him sacked.
Nice Boonwell was called in by his employers and asked if he'd made this impious atheistic film, which Salvador Dali had disowned.
Donc, il était sur le pavé.
Beaumont said, yes, of course. And they sacked him. All right, a few days later, Boonwell and Darley run into each other on Fifth Avenue. Darley sticks out his mitt, which Boonwell refuses to shake. Boonwell says, it was you who got them to give me the boot, wasn't it? And stuck one on him. Monsieur Boonwell, you hit Salvador Darley. Is that correct? If surreal is now just another word for odd, the one thing that cannot be described as surreal is pictorial surrealism, which is...
Hey, you! What's that you were saying about it coming from the South and being royal? Bollocks! It comes from the West. It's Republican.
Bobby Sands was a provisional surrealist. He sought the infant within the man. In his most celebrated work, he pursued nostalgie de la boue with a fervour and literality that even the coprophile Dali never succumbed to. Dali's medium was paint. Sands went much further. He adopted a stratagem of Marcel Duchamp's and created an ever-mutating installation which he knew no one would ever see, which he knew would be destroyed after his death, which was also a surrealist act. Gratuitous, anarchic, irrational, romantic, and truly heroic.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, Holy Mary, Mother of God, Holy Mary, Mother of God, Holy Mary, Mother of God!
Even when there is no train, the tunnel is still there.
To the British, Hitchcock is a manufacturer of thrillers, and Lewis Carroll is a mere children's writer. Continental Europe regards them differently, reveres them as great artists, inventors, artificers, de facto surrealists, who delve, literally as often as not, beneath the surface skein of the observable world.
I'm forever.
So is Lewis Carroll.
Not so forever as me, my dear. The creator lives merely by leave of his creatures, his creations. They buried me here in 1934. I am forever, aren't I?
I am forever, aren't I?
That's the power of myth, of art, of fiction, of imagination. It causes eternity to beckon. It kills off the notion of there being no life after body death,